Yeah, I just put them on the site. No, they were sold out. Oh, they're nice. Yeah, they're nice. Real nice. $29.99, I believe. They're like a light gray color. No, it's on mute. No, I muted it. Oh, it's not. I'm sorry about that. My name's Zach Bogle. I'm the current CEO and founder of Stalemates, the number one fastest growing wrestling media outlet slash podcast in the game right now. I would consider myself a wrestling consumer expert as I have read hundreds and hundreds of forums, listened to a bunch of wrestling podcasts, watched hundreds of dual meets, go to Division I Nationals every year. I read a lot of articles. You name it, I'm on it. I should be an expert in this case because I have watched probably more court footage than anybody else, and I have a very accurate pulse on the wrestling community. Therefore, I think I am overqualified for this position, and I withdraw my name. Thank you. But before I go, we have now restocked our Stalemates crew necks. You can check it out at the link in the description, stalemates.bigcartel.com. Check it out, $29.99, the number one crew neck in the game. Go buy yourself one. Let's get started. We are back. It's been a little bit now. We have had quite the layoff. I finally got some time to spend with my new wife. We've been married now for a few weeks. But all that aside, though, let's get to it. We had a very short court case today. It started at 2 o'clock. It got over at 5 because you guys know, like I've said before, these guys don't work overtime, okay? Nobody can afford that. It's overtime. It's Thursday. It's almost Friday. Regardless, though, they put in 3 hours of court today, and we actually only got to see about an hour and a half or an hour, 2 hours of it, something like that, because a lot of it was spent behind closed chambers because the second witness on the stand was Aubrey Davis, not to be confused with Aubrey Graham. Shout out to Drake. Shout out to Toronto. But Aubrey Davis is basically, he said that he helped set up the Periscope, which if you guys have paid attention by now, Periscope is where they ran a lot of their analytics stuff. And so we could not be there to listen, and neither could Willie and neither could Martin, I believe. So we weren't the only ones getting left out. We will get to Aubrey Davis later. But first, the new star of the show. We had a new character represented in this wonderful saga that we have experienced over the past few weeks, really over the past few months. This thing's been going on for a while now, and that man is Mr. Alan Wolk. Okay, Alan Wolk was brought in by Flo because he is a competition analysis expert, and he is the author of a very well-selling book, according to him, author of Over the Top something something something. So basically he was brought in to tell us whether or not they were competition. And at first it actually almost got shut down right away because Martha Dickey had an objection to get him the fuck out of there. And basically it got overruled by Mrs. Livingston, or Judge Livingston, should I say. I don't know if she's married or not, but it got overruled because she said, you know what? I don't know if I'm going to take anything that he's going to say seriously or not, but hey, we got time. This thing's been going on forever. What's a few more hours? So she lets this guy end up blessing us with his expertise. And did he bless us? Yes, we did. It was actually some good content. Very short today, like I said, but some very good content in there and some good zingers here and there. And an all-time Stalemates moment, okay? I've been waiting this whole time to get our name brought up in the trial, and we have finally arrived, okay? We are Thanos. We got our final Infinity Stone or whatever. I actually don't watch Avengers. I know I used that GIF today, but to come clean, I've never seen it. So anyways, we'll get to that. Stay with us. But first, hit subscribe, hit the notifications button, give us a like. We've been getting like 200 likes, which is insane, okay? Before we were getting like 20 likes, 30 likes, whatever, whatever. We're literally getting 200 some likes, and every video, I love it. Drop a comment down below as well. Let's get into Alan Wolk's testimony. Right off the bat, Karen let us play a game of alphabet soup with Mr. Wolk, where we talked about what POV means, point of view, what DTC means, which means direct to consumer, and what OTT, yeah, you know me, means, which means over the top, aka anything that is not cable. So internet and anything that's streamed online is OTT, DTC, direct to consumer, which means anything that doesn't use like MediaCom or something like that. So no middleman, and then POV, point of view. nonsense. Let's get back to it. So he basically gets questioned on how he came to the analysis that he thinks that Flo and Rockfin are competition. He said he talked with Phil Wendler, which was a previous guest in this trial. Phil Wendler was one of the first witnesses, I believe. He's a Flo guy. And he talked to, so he talked to Phil, he talked to Karen, and then he did his own research, aka checked out Rockfin on his own. And he said he takes, he doesn't go into analytics and marketing stuff. He looks at it as a consumer point of view. And that is where we get brought in. Okay, so as soon as I heard him say that, I said, okay, well, I'm kind of siding here with Martha Dickey and Brutico and all the people on the other side, which is, how is he more of an expert than anybody else? So basically, they brought this guy in to say, will this steal attention from Flow Wrestling's consumers? Because they're trying to basically get into the minds of us. Okay, look at us now. We are the experts. We are the actual people in the wrestling world that pay attention to this stuff. Okay, we are a niche audience, very niche, and we are the ones that decide where our dollars go, where we want to spend our money. And they bring in this big wig, Alan Wolk, whatever his name is, Alan Wolk, to try to tell us where we spend our money and who gets our content and stuff. And by doing that, they're trying to block somebody that we want to spend our dollars on, aka Willie. That whole thing is mind-blowing. I took to my Twitter and I said, let's see what I said here. I said, if any lawyer is reading this and you need a wrestling consumer expert, I'm your guy. Because I've been consuming wrestling media for a long time now. So, you know, in my mind, I was just trying to save them some dollars, okay? Apparently, this Alan Wolk guy testified that he was getting paid $500 an hour to be an expert witness. So he was getting paid $500 an hour to tell us what Rockfin is and what Flow is. But newsflash, I think we know exactly what each of those are, probably more than anybody in that courtroom outside of Martin and outside of Willie. And so I think this whole thing was kind of a waste of time with Alan Wolk, I'm not going to lie. But it made for some good moments. And one of those good moments, which a lot of the good moments in this thing has come down to the hot mic situation. So another favorite moment of mine is when Martin and Karen were going back and forth on blocking out phone numbers, because if you guys remember, Karen was displaying these exhibits where people's phone numbers were being left up on the screen and people were screenshotting those and posting those around the internet and this and that. And then Karen, she was mad because one of Rockfin's exhibits had a phone number and Christian Piles was getting texted this and that. And so she was trying to block that. And so that's when Martin chimed in and said, no, you guys didn't block it for us. So why should we block it for you? If you want that same treatment, do it for us. There was this kind of back and forth. That stuff was in the cracks. So that wasn't really during the trial. That was in these hot mic moments. And today, an all-time moment happened with Stalemates and Company. In the hot mic situation today, you know, I was working today, and so I actually missed a little bit of that, and I missed this. So all of a sudden, I'm sitting there, you know, I'm working, whatever, I'm standing there, and my phone starts blowing up, like going crazy. Apparently, what happened is they had some sort of notice. They must be watching this stuff, so shout out to you guys. Thank you for all of this. We got a bunch of new followers from this happening, but they must have read the tweet that I said where I, you know, said that I was a consumer expert and I volunteered to be a witness. And they said, should we call Stalemates to the stand? Something along those lines. They said, let me get the real quote. They said, should we call Stalemates to the stand as a witness? Apparently, I think how it was relayed to me is that Kelly said it and then Brutico said it and said that Kelly had told him that I had volunteered to do that. And so at that point, I believe Martin chimed in and was like, hey, you guys aren't muted. This is live. And they said, no, I muted it. I'm muted. Like, no, you're not. They went and unmuted it. So your boy got a shout out on the trial. We have pierced the fourth wall, as somebody on Twitter said. So big moment for us. All I'm trying to do here is help out people. I'm just trying to help out the good people at the 261st District Court in Travis County, Texas. Okay, so if you guys need me, I'll give you my number. DM me. I'll be there. I'll tell you whether they're competition or not. I'll tell you what to do. I'll tell Judge Livingston how it is, and then she will probably promptly roast me back and put me back into my place. However, if you need me, call your boy, all right? Enough about me. My head's already big enough. Let's get back to it. So then they bring up Brock Finn and the content creators and how much of it was wrestling and how much of it wasn't. And when they bring up how much of it was wrestling, he said it was a goodly percentage, which I don't even know if that's a word or not. That might be one of those weird words that is a word, but sounds like it's not. I don't know. But he said there was a goodly percentage that was wrestling specific. They also talk about how Rockfin and Flow Sports is competing for audience and content. So that's how they compete, is in two different ways, is in audience and then the actual content itself, like live events. He says the biggest difference between Flow and Rockfin is the subscription model. So Flow charges you by the year, where Rockfin charges you by the month. And then they also bring up Kale's podcast episode that he did with Bosch Mania. Shout out to Bosch Mania. And that gets brought up a lot. And I'm not exactly sure why, because it was objected and sustained, so we really didn't get to dive into that. I was kind of curious, but I want to say that they were going to get into that. I think it was brought up eventually that Kale had said that they were in competition. Kale somehow has an appearance in every episode, so that was kind of par for the course. So then it's time for Mr. Brutico to analyze Mr. Alan Wolk. One of the first things that he asks is how he analyzed Rockfin, and he responds by checking out the content, the comments underneath of it, trying to figure out the whole model. So they basically paid this guy $500 an hour to scroll around on Rockfin for a little bit. I'm sure if he heard me say that, he'd probably laugh, but that's kind of how I took it. Brutico then questions him on how he is more of an expert than the court and how he has experience that the court does not have, which I think is valid. But apparently this guy knows media and how it works more than anybody else, so we're going to take his word for what it is. Hopefully it helps Judge Livingston out. We'll see. Brutico also brings up the fact that if Flow Wrestling wanted to have its own Rockfin channel, it could, to which Wolk agrees. However, Rockfin does approve its content creators, so I highly doubt that they would approve Flow Wrestling to have a Rockfin channel, but maybe they would. Maybe that's the cross promotion that we need in this sport. And at the very end, they discuss whether or not Mr. Wolk is an ad man. They called him an ad man, and he says, "I am not an ad man." And they said, "Well, on your resume, it says that you specialize in advertising." He says, "Yeah, but I'm not an ad man." Okay, all right. All right, I brought it up at the beginning of the video, and it is time to bring Aubrey Davis to the stand. So Aubrey Davis works for Flow Sports. I don't exactly know his title, and right now I'm a little too lazy to look it up. But basically, he's in charge of setting up the Periscope. So that's kind of the only part that we really got to hear, because right away they wanted to bring him to the closed chamber. So we didn't really get to hear a lot of what he had to say. However, one thing that we did get to hear was Soltero brought up the fact that Aubrey Davis was the one who cut Willie off from the Periscope on November 3rd. And he says, yes, he did. And they said that he did not have access after that. And he says that should be the case. So that was pretty big, because Flo was alleging that Willie had access afterwards, but we saw from some of the emails earlier in this case that that was not the case, and now we actually get to ask the source himself directly, DTC, direct to the source, just kidding, that's not what that stands for, whether or not he was cut off, and he says yes he was, and he should not have had access after that, so there you go. They also talked about how other Flow verticals, so like Flow Track, Flow Gymnastics, Flow Marching Band, they get charged monthly, but wrestling fans, Flow Wrestling fans, get charged yearly. I'm guessing that's because a large portion of wrestling fans probably cancel their subscription come March, and then they start it up again in November so they can watch the college season. They kind of talked about that a little bit. They say they see that behavior a lot. And they did talk about one loophole. They put out a pretty good loophole in there. So if you're down to save some dollars, you can sign up for Flow Wrestling in November. And then when the season's over, you can actually say, "Hey, you know what? I don't really like wrestling anymore. I'm more of a Flow Marching Band fan now. So can you switch my account from being a Flow Wrestling fan to a Flow Marching Band subscriber?" And they'll say, yeah, we can do that. And when you switch it over, then you are eligible to cancel it on a month-to-month basis instead of a yearly contract. So little loophole, that's what you get for watching the Stalemate Show. We provide you the stuff that you missed, and that's something that you might have missed if you didn't get to watch the trial or if you didn't scroll around on Twitter. But nevertheless, I hope you guys like this video. Tomorrow's the big day. When you're watching this, it's today. So today's the big day. We're going to find out what's going to happen to Willie. I'm interested to see how Judge Livingston is going to rule. I'm also excited to get some rest and to start moving on to some other content. So this weekend, we're going down to Boys Creek, North Carolina to check out the Campbell University Camels, and we're going to check out the Wrestle-Offs. I'm very excited for that. Make sure you're subscribed to our channel so you can get more content if you guys like this stuff. If you want to support us as well, you can go to www.stalemates.bigcartel.com. You can find that in the link in the description down below. Peace.